ओके गुड मॉर्निंग डियर्स, माय नेम इज़ वीरा बाबू। आई एम वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इन सेंट मार्टिन्स इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। सो इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, इंट्रोडक्शन टू द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। सो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इज अ सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर। व्हाट इज द सॉफ्टवेयर? सो हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर, एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर, सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर। What is the major role of operating system? What are the objectives of operating system? So, what are the advantages? So, these topics we discussed in the last session. Today, we are going to discuss types of the operating system. We are going to discuss types of the operating system. Types of the operating systems. So first one is the we have a different types of the operating systems. So one like a mobile operating system, network operating system, distributed operating system, serial operating system, an embedded operating system, time sharing operating system, real time operating system, batch operating system. So like this, all of the operating different types of the operating system. Majorly we are going to discuss five operating systems. So first one is a batch operating system. Second one is distributed operating system. Third one is time sharing operating system. Fourth one is embedded operating system. Fifth one is real time operating system. These five majorly we are going to discuss in this operating system. So first, coming to the first one is a batch operating system. So what is a batch operating system? Coming to the first, batch operating system. So batch operating system, first, for example, if you are in your classroom, 60 students are there. So for going to theory classes, 60 students will be present in the class. So when you are going to lab sessions, so you are dividing into batch wise. For example, 1 to 20 members one batch, 21 to 40 members second batch, like that. So one batch is going to one lab, second batch is going to another lab, third batch is going to some other lab. So like that, in such a way that batch operating system also is the same, but here we don't have a students, we don't have a jobs, we don't have a jobs. So what is mean by job? Job is nothing but, what is mean by job? Job is programs, input data, and control instructions. This is completely the job. This is completely known as a job. Job is nothing but programs, input data, control instructions. We have a different types of, for example, if you take a job one, you have several jobs here and there. Job one, job two, job three, job four, job five, job six. So here, what is the main, what is the exact meaning of batch operating system? Batch operating system is a non-interactive operating system. Non-interactive operating system means, so user cannot communicate with the system directly. User cannot interact with the system directly. That is a non-interactive operating system. So between the user and batch operating system, one operator is there. So for example, job one is doing some task on the system. He wants to write some programs in program. So that program should be in the punch cards, in the form of a punch cards. So job, what he will do is leave one program in the punch cards. Punch cards, like this is a punch card, like this is a punch card. The dot means binary one. This empty space is a binary zero. Why? Because system, the batch operating system understand only these two numbers, that is a binary one and a zero. So that is the reason job one is preparing the data in the form of a punch cards. Job, that is the reason. The batch is a punch card, means binary 1 and 0. The batch operating system understand only the 0s and 1s. So that is the reason the Java 1 is preparing the tasks in the form of a punch card. After preparing the punch cards, after completion of his task, so he has to submit the task to the operator. So who is operator? Operator is nothing but user. So operator, what he will do? Operator is doing, so operates the operating system. He is operating the complete operating system. Why? Because he is well known person about the batch operating system. Right? So operator is doing. In between our users and batch operating system, one operator is there. After completion of writing their task, so they need to submit their task to the operator. So batch one submits their jobs into the operator. So after submission, so they have to wait. So operator, what he will do, he is taking the input from the jobs and he is segregate and he is dividing their according their needs. So for example, job 1 is using the C code, C language. Job 2 is using the Java. Job 3 is using the C. Job 4 is using the Java. Job 5 is using the C. Job 6 is using the Java. So we have a different jobbers is there. So each job using the separate language to prepare the task, they prepare the programs. So after completion of their task, they have to submit to the operators. Operator, what he will do, he is dividing the jobs. So first, divide the similar kind of jobs and add it into the batch, one batch. So for example, batch one is there. So what are the similar jobs is there? Job one is, first job 1, job 3, next job 5. So these three members are using same language to write their, to complete their task. So right, this is called as a batch 1. This is a batch 1. We can call it as a batch 1. Right? Next, remains similar kinds of jobs. What are there? So next remains similar kind of jobs is job 2, next job 4 and job 6. So this is, we can call it as a batch 2. So operator is dividing the jobs and added into the batch wise according the similar jobs. So right, this is completion after dividing the batches. So operator will submit the batch 1 into the operating system, into the system. Here system is there.
So batch 1 is submitted to the operating system.
Who will submit the operator will submit the CPU, submit the system, computer system. So after submitting, so CPU will processing that data and it will produce the output. So here output also in the form of a punch cards. So output also in the form of a punch card. After completion of batch 1, so then only you will insert the next batch. Otherwise you are not able to insert the batch 2. So while running the batch 1, while processing the batch 1 in stock, so user not able to insert the batch 2. So still after completion of batch 1, then only you can insert the batch 2 punch cards into the system. Right? This is the batch operating system. Right? Next topic is I hope you clear this. So next topic is distributed operating system. Distributed operating system. What is the distributed operating system? So distributed operating system means the collection of computers connected together in a single network. Collection of computers connected, interconnected between the via through internet. Understand? Collection of independent computers interconnected via network. Single network. That network also connected with the server. That answer. What is independent computers means what? So it not depends on any other systems. That is called as independent computer. Their collection of independent computers interconnected via network. For example, the client, that is a computer take as a client. Take it as a client, a client 1, a client 2, a client 3, right? Client, example, these clients are connected through a network. This is a network. This network is connected with the server. This is the server. Right? The client 1 is connected in network. Client 2 also connected in network. Client 3 also to n number of clients. These are all the independent clients, independent computers. The computer. Right? Computers. So here, client 1 using one computer, client 2 using one computer, client 3 is using another computer, client 2 and also using one computer. Different clients are using different computers. Every client is using the independent computer. Independent computer means it's not connected to any other computer systems. So here these clients are not sharing any memory to the other systems. They are sharing their data only, their information only. So they are sharing only their information or data. So they are not sharing any memory. So they are connecting with the one single network layer, and this network is also connected with the server. So first client is send the request to the server. First client 1 is sent to the request to the server. For example, client 1 client one wants to do some task on your system. They are using the some application. They are doing some task. So they need to pass the request to the server. Then only server will process and it gives the result to the clients. It gives the result back to the clients. That is a distributed operating system in government. So where we are using the distributed system? For example, telephone is using using the distributed system. Banking application using the distributed system, right? For example, banking application using the distributed system. There are so many applications, they are using the distributed operating system. So this is about a small overview of the distributed operating system. So majorly, distributed operating system is, what is the exact meaning of distributed operating system is, so collection of independent computers interconnected via network, that is called as a distributed operating system. So next class we will discuss in briefly. Thank you.